for the swing between Watkins Glen and CTMP.
Yeah.
Picked it up in Canada, drove it down, and then drove it back up again.
Have you been in the ATSV?
I've had an ATSV, yes. I had that one before.
On a tight road, forget about it. It's like a little fighter jet.
Let's go down to Jamie. Very heavy impact for Tony Wielander. He was moving around in the car that we could see. Jamie, any news from the team?
Well, you were asking the question. Maybe he had a brake issue, maybe he went to the pedal. He did not say anything. I checked in with Joe LaJoy, the engineer for the Scuderia Corsa team, and he said that he didn't say anything on the radio. They don't think that they had any problems, but if you saw the in-car, and I know you saw it up in the booth, that he really just didn't have any visibility in front of him.
No, nothing at all. Thank you. Thank you, Jamie.
You know, some things happen in racing. Brake failures are rare. Really rare. You know, you're more likely to have a stuck throttle because you pick something up, but not that it doesn't happen.
I was talking the other day in a different environment about just how much the ABS systems on race cars have come on. We're back in the early days of
Thank you.
this rally cross of that. Yeah.
Thank you.
from Collado or Ford from Collado.
Car going behind had to go to the left and go on the grass.
That is very, very dangerous. Harsham gets going again. And the 57 Caterpillar car with Catherine Leigh in that car trying to make up positions. That was a split second decision from Cat as well, and she had to take to the grass.
You know, this is this time in the race, I'd hate to be official, because we're seeing so many guys